All right, Trump versus Clinton, Miller. What do you think?
Well, you know, Billy, I just made a decision earlier today that I'm going for Kasich. What's that?
He's not there anymore.
Oh, God. I had no idea.
Yeah. He's out.
All right, Johnny. Sorry about that. You know, Kasich actually, I just saw on Google, he's invaded the White House with the Ohio National Guard because he says he can't wait anymore. And then he told the chef to get him some Skyline chili and a bear claw.
You've been tough on Kasich.
Yeah, Clinton.
You've been tough on him.
Yeah, Billy, I know you like him.
I think he did a great job.
I think he did a great job.
He's not a moron. Yeah, he did a great job in Ohio.
Best human ever.
Listen, Miller, the facts are the facts. He ran the state well. Come on.
All right, Billy, we can shut it down here. I'm kind of teasing. I don't think he's the worst human being ever. You're right.
Good, I'm glad.
I think he's been a bad presidential candidate who should have dropped out a long time ago.
All right.
We just disagree on that. Trump versus Clinton. You know, they gave Trump this big window because nature abhors a vacuum, and Donald Trump is a force of nature, and the liberals just played this stupidly. She lies about things she doesn't even have to lie about. She lies about Benghazi. They forced Obamacare through. We've given money to Iraq, and we're estranged from Israel. We got no border. All this stuff has yielded people who, even people who by and large don't even want to get involved, they're saying, wait, you've gone too far. It's too crazy now. And you know, when they tell you incessantly that Trump cannot beat Clinton, you know, they're telling you that incessantly because they do, and I think they are a little afraid, that he could beat her because she's not a great candidate. And you know something else? I think that if he really wanted to seal the deal with women, he should run as the first father-daughter ticket and have his girl Ivanka run with him as the VP. She's very impressive. Now, I saw a Rasmussen poll that says Trump has moved ahead of her in a head-to-head battle for the president of the United States, although she still leads in a head-to-head battle with him to be president of Mexico. So listen, it's still all up in the air, but I would say this, they left him a big opening by trying to sell too much crap to the American people.
Okay.
Oh, and by the way, Billy, I just heard this in other political news. Joe Biden has signed on to become the third guy in the car in the Sonic commercials. So that's going to be exciting. Him sitting in the back going, I want some nuggets. What's a new Slurpee?
You got to look ahead. You just have to look ahead. Now.
But listen, Kasich, the best guy ever. Now, let's talk about Bloomberg.
You're out kicking your coverage here. I have to run the soundbite. Mayor Bloomberg, former mayor of New York City, goes to the University of Michigan to give the commencement address. Roll it.
Beautiful.
The whole purpose of college is to learn how to deal with difficult situations, not to run away from them. A microaggression is exactly that, micro. But in a macro sense, one of the most dangerous places on a college campus is the so-called safe space, because it creates a false impression that we can isolate ourselves from those who hold different views.
All right, what do you think?
I think that's a micro podium if he's that far above it, Bloomberg. Listen, Bloomberg's part of this. He's part of the nanny state. See, this is the thing. You can't have guys saying that they think people shouldn't do something like, I don't want you to have a certain size drink, and then down the road not understand that you're part of the problem, Mike Bloomberg. People should decide for themselves. I'm a bit of an objectivist on this stuff. People make their own decisions. Bloomberg has done some of this nanny state stuff. This is the yield of the nanny state. You know, when I first knew it was going to hit, it was overseas. It's like a contagion. I saw kids in Paris who were worried about their health benefits in their 60s, 20-year-old kids flipping cars over in Paris, and I thought, that's what the nanny state does. It takes kids who live in a country that invented the phrase joie de vivre, and it makes them think about 40 years hence what their medical benefits are going to be. Liberals have done this to kids with the safe space. Bloomberg has done this to kids with the drinks and all this no salt on the table. This is the yield of the nanny state, a generation of emotional hemophiliacs who overreact to everything. There you go, liberals. You wanted it. You got it. What are you going to do with it?
Very good, Miller. Very astute this evening. All right, let's give him a hand and a quick reminder.
Hey, listen, Billy, pretend this is Kasich.
I knew it. I knew you were going to get Kasich. I knew
it. You're the best little guy.
Get out of here, Miller. You're done.
You're the best.
All right, quick reminder that the Who Wants to Be President show, starring Miller and me, rolls into Fairfax, Virginia this coming Saturday.